Hello everyone, welcome back to Ideas Model Kitchen, and today we are going to discuss about sinks. A lot of people have been asking us various kinds of questions regarding sinks. What kind of brand should they buy? What is a good price range? What are the factors that they need to look for in a sink for themselves? So today we are going to do a deep dive into it, and let's get started. So first of all, before you go ahead and try to look for a sink, understand the kind of utility and the usage that you'll be having it. So you need to understand the kind of volume of utensils that you have and the frequency at which they'll be washed. So some of the basic factors that you can take into account is, like, you know, if you have a big family and most of the utensils are being washed within a single kitchen, so you'll be requiring a big sink because the utensils would be of huge volume and probably the frequency of them being washed would also be high. That might not be the case for some places. Maybe nuclear families will not be having that kind of a huge volume. It also depends upon the type of cuisine. Sometimes people have a culture in which they need to make multiple dishes, different kinds of vegetables in the same meal. That obviously leads to much more frequency of washing of various appliances, various food processors, as well as the basic cutleries. So that might also be a second factor. And the third factor might also be habits. Like, some people generally, they have a habit of, have a frequent habit of, you know, having tea and coffee and drinks and so on and so forth, which leads to having a much more high volume for these kind of utensils to be washed. So these are the things that one needs to basically just keep in their mind as to what would be the volume and what would be the frequency at which these dishes are supposed to be washed. And once you have that somewhat clear and you keep that in the back of your head, and then we can go ahead and look at the various kinds of sinks that are available in the market. We can basically divide the type of sinks on the basis of materials in 2 to 3 categories. The first category is basically SS304 steel, and the second one is basically quartz. There's also, people generally make it in stone slabs. Also in traditional kitchens, people used to make it through stone slabs, and it has some downsides to it, and we'll come to it. So starting off from the SS304 or the steel sink. These sinks are also called quadro sinks nowadays. In that, these are very durable, and they don't rust at all. They generally sometimes get dented if, you know, the usage is very rough. Apart from that, it's a very hygienic, durable, and they look really great. They have a very nice sheen to it, and it does not, you know, one doesn't need to worry about basic stains and keeping in hot utensils that might damage it, or, you know, stains that might get absorbed by porous surfaces because it's steel, so it does not absorb those kind of stains. So it's really utilitarian in that way, and helps most people to keep their sinks clean in a very easy way. The downside of the quadro sinks, the SS304 sinks, is basically that it generally creates a lot of noise because they are metals, and most of the utensils and dishes are metal. There's a lot of clanking, there's a lot of voice during washing, and even the basic noise of water running onto it is generally very high. So that's a basic downside of going into the steel sinks. In steel sinks also, there are particularly two kinds. One which has a more straight line angles to it, which are 90 degree angles. It's been cut completely on it. And the other ones are basically which have little curved corners to it. These are some traditional steel sinks that you see. So the ones which are straight line cut, which have very nice right 90 degree angles, so these are generally a little more expensive. They give a much more elegant look. But apart from that fact, the point is that the technology to actually cut the metal on in such a straight line in a very seamless way is more expensive. And that is the reason why these things are more expensive as compared to the other rounded ones. And the ones which are rounded, they're not exactly rounded, they're actually bent. So it's not like they are cut in a round way. The metal has been folded a bit over there, which is a little old technology, a little common technology, that's why it's available at a somewhat cheaper rate. Moving on to the next material on sinks is quartz. Now these are synthetic man-made stone materials. One of the few great qualities about quartz is that because it's man-made, they are available in various kinds of designs, they are available in various kinds of colors, as well as they have, you can get different patterns onto it. There are like patterns of black with having white or silver mineral-like finishes to it. They have like sandstone finishes to it, which actually helps a designer, you know, give a designer element to the kitchen. It makes sure that, you know, there are more color options available to choose from. So that's a real big plus from an aesthetics point of view. The other great point is that because it is made of man-made synthetic stone, the noise level is really well controlled. So there will be less clanking, less noise of water running into the sink. So the entire process becomes very, very, less, you can say, loud. And that's a plus, specifically if the frequency of washing the utensils is very high, I believe. Because that makes sure that the daily cumbersome process of a kitchen is, you know, much more bearable and with less noise, specifically, you know, from all the sink area. So that is a plus from these quartz sinks. So these are the two positives of it. It's generally cheaper from as compared to the Quadro sinks, which are the straight line SS303304 sinks. They are still expensive as compared to your basic steel sinks, which have rounded corners. But they have these good advantages to it. The small downside that one might say to it is that it generally gets stains sometimes because we have, you know, in Indian cuisine we use a lot of masalas, we use a lot of spices, so they might start getting stains to it because it's a slightly porous material, so it starts absorbing some of these things. But that happens after quite a good amount of time, like 7-8 years, and it might actually not happen even after 7-8 years if the maintenance of the sink is done well, if it is cleaned in a proper way at the right intervals. So that is also that's why like quartz like comes very high on our list of recommendation during sink, that one should probably look for quartz sinks. The last material we can talk about is the basic stone slabs. People used to make sinks by putting together stone slabs together and then, you know, pasting them through various kind of adhesive. This was used in traditional kitchens. It had a lot of, it was very cumbersome. The corners, the joints used to have leakages. It used to have hygiene issues also. There would be stains also on it from time to time because it was a highly porous material and it absorbed all these kinds of stains here and there. So it's not something which is recommended. Some people use it nowadays as a designer element, to add a big designer element in which, you know, they try to carve out a sink out of one stone piece, or sometimes even try to have beautiful stone slabs put together. We don't think it's very practical, and it seems it's a relatively cumbersome process though. So we don't recommend that. So moving on. The other aspects while you are looking for a sink is basically the design, and these basically come in various kinds of design. We have basically a single bowl, which is just like one bowl, one sink area, that's it. Then we have a single bowl with drainer, in which there is a drainer attached to it. You can stack up your clean utensils and dishes. Then we have a double bowl, in which you have two bowls. One might be big, one might be small, or you know, both could be of equal sizes, that one can figure out as compared to the volume that they want. And then we have both double bowl with drainer, in which again you have a drainer to stack up your clean utensils. We generally don't recommend a drainer a lot because generally people do have a dish rack separately and they choose to put their clean utensils over there directly. But people might want to have a drainer otherwise, because it helps with the spilling of the water make sure that your other areas in your countertop are relatively less wet because of that. So that is a thing that that's a personal choice over there as to how they want to how they want to go about keeping the utensils. So these are the basic design types. So another one is basically an L-shaped sink. We generally try not to design a kitchen in which, you know, you have an L-shaped sink because it takes up a lot of space. It's a little cumbersome to have it in the corner of a kitchen. It should probably be in a straight line area where the volume can be much more spread out and easily manageable. So that's why you don't have it in the corner. But there are L-shaped sinks in which you can have a single bowl, double bowl, or, you know, single bowl with drainer. You're gonna have drainer on both sides also over there. And one can look into it as per their own and figure out, you know, what kind of a volume that they are looking at, and the frequency at which they wash the they want to wash their utensils. They can choose their design as per that. But if you are having a high volume in which you need to have, you know, you have really big utensils to be washed, but maybe the frequency is not that big. Maybe, you know, it's a normal frequency. So you might want to go for a double bowl, or if the volume is less, maybe you're a nuclear family, or maybe, you know, you just have too many mugs and you're an avid drinker. So in that case, you might want to go for a single bowl also, single bowl with drainer, that might do well. So one needs to figure that out a little bit, and then they can figure out the design. So these are the basic. So now we've covered the material and the design for these things. What's left is the basic brands. So generally, we have Carousel, Frankie, Nilkant, Genya. Yeah, we have a lot of these brands available out there. We generally do go for Frankie or Carousel. These are good imported brands, specifically for SS304 and quartz sinks. The quality is very nice and durable. Apart from that, in the Indian market, we have Genya, we have Nilkant. These are great quality brands. The sink material is very nice. The company service is also great. So we generally recommend those in the Indian market. And that's it for the video. I hope you found it informational. I hope you learned from it and it was helpful. Do let us know in the comments what you thought about it. If you have any questions regarding it, do share this video with people who are making their kitchens. We would like to help them out. You are also into interiors, so do share it with people who are, you know, making their homes. Like, subscribe, and let us know. We're also coming up with more interior videos, so do let us know if you want something like that. Thank you for watching, and have a good day.